I will apply snowflakes on this cute image with this little girl who is making a snowman. It's an awesome photo that I've downloaded from bigstockphoto.com. But let me show you how this template works, because this is why you're watching this video, right? So when you open the file, you will see a group of layers here called snowflakes. Open the group and you will notice three different layers here: back, middle, and front. Also, each layer has a layer mask. You will see why in a few moments. And each layer has the same smart filters applied, the Gaussian blur filter and the motion blur filter, and they can be readjusted at any point. This is the beauty of this template. You will work non-destructively. But Chris, why did you create three different layers of snowflakes, you may ask? Because I want to control the snowflakes on each plane. So I prepared a professional sketch for you, as you can see. Ha ha, this should be a top view, but I didn't know how to draw the person from the top. So now this guy is laid down on the snow. He's chilling, but I hope you understand. In real life, you won't see snowflakes with the same size, right? Some of them are really far. This is why I created the back layer. The snowflakes are very small, and if you have a blurred background, you can also blur the snowflakes on this layer. Then you have the middle layer, which is used for the objects in your photo, which are in focus. The snowflakes are a bit bigger, and then you have the snowflakes which are falling between your camera and the subject. These snowflakes are even bigger, and maybe these are more blurred if you use the small depth of field when you took the photo. One more thing to mention, this template has a resolution of approximately 25 megapixels, so it should be enough for the majority of the photos that you may take, if you have a smartphone or a DSLR which has lots of megapixels. Now let's play with this image and add some snowflakes. Here comes the fun part. Make sure you also open the template. You will have to grab with the mouse this group called snowflakes, drag it onto your image, and let go of the mouse. In a couple of seconds, the group will be imported, but of course it depends on how fast your computer is. Okay, grab the selection tool. Make sure you select group here, not layer, because I want to move the whole group together and place it exactly where I want, and resize it depending on the resolution of my photo. To resize the group proportionally, hold down the shift key, click once on the corner point. A message will show up maybe saying that the smart filters will be turned off while you scale the group. It's not a problem, just hit OK. Press again the shift and resize the whole group as you want. While the snowflakes group is selected, change the blending mode to screen, and this will maintain only the snowflakes while hiding the black background. And here we go. The image looks very good already, but we are not finished yet. So hold your horses. You have to make it look more real than this, because you see, if I zoom in, these don't look like real snowflakes. They are just white shapes on the screen. Control 0 to fit your image on the screen. Hide the front and middle layers. So you begin with the back layer. Hit B for the brush. Make sure you choose black. Select the layer mask on this layer and start hiding some snowflakes from the face of the girl. You don't want to cover that part too much with white. And also, let's hide some snowflakes on her clothes. Now, I double-click the Gaussian blur filter and I enter a value of 1. Yeah, it looks good. Hit OK. Now, I double-click the motion blur filter and I add a value of 3. This is just to simulate that the snowflakes are falling, so it looks more real. Okay, I will unhide the middle layer. This layer is in focus because this is the place where my subject is, so it's not necessary to use the Gaussian blur. However, it's up to you. I made it available in the template for each of the layers, but I will double click the motion blur filter and I will enter 5 here. Let's see a preview. Nice, that looks good. So I'm gonna hit OK. I will use the layer mask of the middle layer, grab the brush tool with the B on the keyboard and paint with black to hide again some snowflakes from the girl's face. I want to keep her face clear, she's so cute. It's time to unhide the front layer. I will double click the Gaussian blur and enter a value of, let's say, 6. Nope, it's too much. Let's try 4. Yes, hit OK. Double click the motion blur and I will choose 14 here. And then hit OK. I don't need to hide any snowflakes on this layer. None of them is covering the girl's face, but you can use it because you will have, of course, a different image. And we are done here, guys. You can modify any filter from this template just by double-clicking it. If you want to double the amount of snowflakes on a layer, just select it, press Ctrl-J to duplicate it, and then go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Vertical. And now you have a double amount of snowflakes in the front plane, and you can do this for any of the layers. Let me show you what you need to do if you have a vertical image. You just bring in the group called snowflakes onto your image, and then you go to Edit, Transform, and rotate 90 degrees clockwise. You resize it, put the group on the screen blending mode, and then you apply the same process like for the horizontal photo. And of course, you use the layer masks to hide snowflakes from the face or clothes if needed. Don't forget to subscribe and have fun with this template. This is Chris, catch you in the next one.